students, welcome to the e-learning. In today's class, let's learn about metals and nonmetals from the NCERT Science of Class 8. The first part of the topic includes the introduction of metals and nonmetals and the physical properties of metals and nonmetals. The second part of the topic includes chemical properties of metals and nonmetals, displacement reaction, and uses of metals and nonmetals. Metals and nonmetals. The universe is made up of matter and energy. Matter is anything that occupies space and has mass. Matter exists as solid, liquid, gas. Matter also exists as pure and impure. The pure form of matter is classified as element and compound. Element is the pure form of matter that cannot be broken down into two or more simpler substances by chemical reaction on applying heat, light, or electricity. Examples of element are gold, silver, copper, iron, zinc, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, sulfur, phosphorus, etc. There are 117 elements that are known to us. Among it, 92 elements occur naturally. The smallest particle of element is atom. And the elements are made up of only one kind of atoms. Compound. It is the pure form of matter that is formed when two or more elements combine chemically in a fixed ratio by mass. Compounds can be broken down into simpler substances by chemical reaction. Examples of compound are water, carbon dioxide, baking soda, sodium chloride, calcium carbonate, methane. There are innumerable compounds. These compounds contain two or more elements in it. Elements are further divided as metal and non-metal. This division is based on the properties they exhibit. The majority of elements are metal. From the known naturally occurring elements, only 22 are non-metals. The structure of an element determines whether it is metal or non-metal. Metal. These are the elements that can form a positively charged atom by the loss of electron. Examples of metal are gold, silver, iron, copper, sodium, potassium, magnesium, aluminium. There are 70 metals that exist naturally. These exist in free state and in combined state. Non-metal. These are the elements that can form a negatively charged atom by accepting one or more electrons. Examples of non-metal are hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, carbon, phosphorus, chlorine, helium, argon. There are 22 non-metals existing naturally. They exist in free state and also in combined state. Physical properties of the metals. The metals and the non-metals differ from each other due to their physical and chemical properties. Physical property. It is the one which can clearly observed or measured without changing the composition of matter. Various physical properties that are discussed are physical state, hardness, luster, density, melting point and boiling point, malleability, ductility, conductivity of heat and electricity, sonority. Physical state. It is the one of the distinct form in which a matter exists at room temperature. All metal exists as solid at room temperature, except mercury. It is the only metal which exists as a liquid at room temperature. Hardness. It is the property exhibited by a matter where it resists towards bending, cutting, scratching or compressing. Metals are generally hard. There is an exception that sodium and potassium are two metals which are very soft. They are so soft that it can be cut easily with knife. Luster. It is the property exhibited by a material when cut and the cut part when exposed to light appears to be shiny. Metals show specific luster called as metallic luster. Lead is the only metal which do not show any metallic luster. Rather, it appears to be dull. Many times, the metal loses its metallic luster due to the exposure to air and water. Density. It is the mass per unit volume of a matter. Density is measured in gram per cubic centimeter in CGS system and kilogram per cubic meter in SI system. The metals usually show high density. Density of gold is 19.3 gram per cubic centimeter. Density of mercury is 13.6 gram per cubic centimeter. However, sodium and potassium are the two metals which exhibit very low density, even lower than water. Hence, when placed in water, they always float on the surface of water. Melting and boiling point. Melting point refers to the fixed temperature at which a solid changes into liquid, and boiling point is the fixed temperature at which a liquid changes into the gaseous state. The melting point and boiling point of metals is generally high. For example, melting point of iron is 1530 degrees Celsius and boiling point of iron is 2786 degrees Celsius. There are some exceptions in which the metals are showing low melting point and boiling point. They are mercury and gallium. Mercury is showing a very low melting point, which is equal to minus 39 degrees Celsius, and boiling point as 357 degrees Celsius. Gallium, the another metal with a very low melting point as 29.7 degrees Celsius. Malleability. It is the ability of a matter to be converted into thin sheets without breaking. Metals are highly malleable. This property helps it making a number of articles such as boxes, containers from various metals such as iron, tin, copper, aluminium. Gold and silver are highly malleable metals. The silver foil used for decorating sweets is a thin sheet of silver. Ductility. It is the ability of matter to be stretched into thin wires without breaking. Metals are highly ductile. This property helps in making number of articles such as jewelry making, cable wires from various metals such as gold, silver, copper, aluminium. Gold and silver are the two metals said to have high ductility. From 1 gram of gold, nearly 2000 meters of long wire can be stretched. Conductivity of heat and electricity. It is the ability of a matter to allow the heat and electricity to pass through it. All metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. This property of metals make it its various uses, as in making of cooking wares, electric gadgets and boilers. The only metal which is poor conductor of heat is lead. Sonority. It is the property of matter where when struck with hard material produces ringing sound that can travel very far. Metals are sonorous in nature. Hence, the bell at school, temple, church are made from metals or their alloy. Physical properties of non-metals. The non-metals show the physical properties. Let's see with physical state. The non-metal exists in all three states: solid, liquid, gas. The solid non-metals are carbon, sulfur, phosphorus. Bromine is the only non-metal that exists as liquid at room temperature. Some non-metals that exist as gas at room temperature are hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, helium, etc. Hardness. The non-metals are generally soft. They can be compressed easily. The exception is diamond, which is said to be the allotropic form of carbon, is the hardest naturally occurring material on earth. Luster. The non-metals show non-luster appearance. They appear to be dull. However, iodine is the only non-metal that appears lustrous as the metals. Density. The non-metals usually exhibit a low density. For instance, hydrogen show density as 0.0899 gram per liter. There is an exception. Diamond, the allotropic form of carbon, show exceptionally high density. The value is 3.5 grams per cc. Melting point and boiling point. The non-metals usually exhibit a low melting point and boiling point. Melting point of nitrogen is minus 210 degrees Celsius and boiling point is minus 196 degrees Celsius. Except diamond, the allotropic form of carbon, which shows relatively very high melting point as 3500 degrees Celsius and boiling point as 4800 degrees Celsius. Another allotropic form of carbon, graphite, which sublimes at 3700 degrees Celsius. Malleability. The non-metal do not show the property of malleability, which means that they cannot be beaten into thin sheets. Ductility. Non-metal do not exhibit the property of ductility, means they cannot be stretched into thin wires. Conductivity of heat and electricity. The non-metals are usually bad conductor of heat and electricity. Graphite is an exception, which is an allotropic form of carbon, is a good conductor of electricity. This makes graphite to be used as electrodes in various fields for conducting electricity. Sonority. The non-metal are non-sonorous in nature. They do not produce ringing sound when struck with the hard objects. Now, let's compare the physical properties of metals and non-metals. Physical appearance or physical state. The metals are solid in state, whereas the non-metals are solid, liquid and gas. Hardness. Metals are usually hard, whereas non-metals are soft in nature. Appearance. The metals show metallic luster, whereas the non-metals are non-lustrous or dull. Density. The metal exhibit a high density, whereas non-metals show a low density. Melting point and boiling point. Metal exhibit comparatively high melting point and boiling point, whereas non-metals show low melting point and boiling point. Malleability. Metals are highly malleable, whereas the non-metals are non-malleable. Ductility. The metals are ductile in nature and they can be stretched into wires, whereas non-metals are non-ductile in nature. Conductivity of heat and electricity. Mostly all the metals are good conductor of heat and electricity. Non-metals are poor or bad conductor of heat and electricity. Sonority. Metals are highly sonorous and they can produce ringing sound, whereas non-metals are non-sonorous and are unable to produce ringing sound. Now, let's have a glance to the summary of the part 1. Matter in pure form exists as element and compound. All elements are classified as metals and non-metals on the basis of their characteristics. Metals and non-metals exhibit different physical properties. Now, let's do some brain drill about the topic by choosing correct answer from the given options. Name the metal that melts when kept on the palm, has melting point lower than human body and body temperature. The options are gallium and mercury. The correct answer is gallium. Next is, name the non-metal that conducts electricity. The options are carbon as graphite and iodine. The correct answer is carbon as graphite. Now let's see the third one. Name a metal that has density less than water. Options are aluminium and sodium. The correct answer is sodium. Now let's see the fourth one. Name the non-metal that is lustrous as metal. The options are lead and iodine. The correct answer is iodine. The fifth one, name the metal that do not conduct heat. The options are silver and lead. The correct answer is lead. Now let's look at the other part of the brain drill. Sodium metal is malleable. True or false? The answer is false. Bell are sonorous as they are of metals. True or false? The answer is true. The boiling point of nitrogen is 210 degrees Celsius. True or false? The answer is false. Metal potassium can be cut with a knife. True or false? The answer is true. The highest ductility is exhibited by gold. True or false? The answer is true. This is all for this class. Thank you.